Hello, Power BI community. Welcome to the Power BI February 2023 update. We've got a lot of exciting features for you this month, but we're going to highlight three of them. Conditional formatting based on string fields, enhanced row-level security editor, and the new Get Data experience in the Power BI service. If you want to hear all about the other features we released this month, find more information on our demos and technical documentation, you can find the link to the Power BI blog post in the description of this video. Let's get started. First up is conditional formatting based on string fields. You can now set conditional formatting rules based on the string fields. We know that many of you have been asking for this feature. We're very excited to be bringing you this feature and hope that you'll find it a new, powerful conditional formatting capability. Let's see this one in action. You can access this new capability in the same way as the other conditional formatting, through the dialog which opens when selecting an option in the formatting pane. For example, in the column charts, you can conditionally format column colors by selecting the FX button in the columns card of the formatting pane. In the dialog, select rules through the format style dropdown, then base these rules on a string field and select a summarization. Before, your summarization options were only numeric, count and count distinct. Now you'll see first and last options as well, which will give you strings to write logic around. Let's add a simple rule here that says if the value of the string is audio, we color the column red. We've added a variety of comparator options to the conditional formatting dialog, including is, start with, ends with, and more. Keep in mind that these comparisons will check your fields against your inputs for exact character matches, including case sensitivity. Once our formatting rule is ready, we hit OK, and the audio columns of our visual will now be read. As always, let us know what you think about these features and ideas you have to improve them or any other aspects of Power BI. Next, let's look at the enhanced row-level security editor. You can now quickly and easily define row-level security roles and filters without having to write any DAX. Select Manage Roles in the ribbon to use the new drop-down interface to create and edit security roles. If you prefer DAX or require DAX for your filter definitions, we support toggling between using the default drop-down editor and a DAX editor. To try out the new enhanced RLS security editor, you must enable this feature by navigating to Options and Settings, Options, Preview Features. Once you enable this feature and restart Power BI Desktop, you can start using the enhanced editor. Let's create a security role based on the Sales Territory table that filters data from the North American Territory Group only to Canada and Central United States. Let's go to the Modeling tab and select Manage Roles. Click New to create a new security role. Let's name the role appropriately. Next, we select the Sales Territory table and use the Add button to add filtering rules. We want this role to see only data for country equals Canada or region equals Central. To add OR logic, we group these two filters and select any options for the group. Also, let's make sure the role will only be able to be accessed from the North American group. This rule is added outside the previously created group of rules, so the AND logic is applied. Notice that we can still switch to the DAX editor to see the generated DAX code and edit it if necessary. Then, you can switch back to the default visual editor. Finally, we click Save to save the newly created security role. To test the role, let's click the View As button and select the Canada and Central US role that we just created. We can see that now the report shows us only the data for Canada and the central region of the United States, just as expected. All changes made in either editor interface will persist when switching interfaces when possible. However, not all row-level security filters are supported in Power BI can be defined using the default editor. Limitations include expressions that can only be defined using DAX, including dynamic rules such as username or user principal name. When defining a role with these limitations in the DAX editor, if you attempt to switch to the default editor, you'll be prompted with a warning that switching editors may result in some information being lost. To keep this information, simply select Cancel and continue only editing this role in the DAX editor. Now, I know what you're thinking. How could RLS be any better? Tell us how you're leveraging RLS in the comments below this video. Well, let's jump right into the last demo for the day, the new Get Data experience in the Power BI service. As we called out in our last blog, we've completed the process of removing the older Get Data page in the Power BI service in favor of a new one with comparable features within workspaces. If you want to upload a file to Power BI, such as a .pbix, XLSX, or RDL file to your workspace, you can use the upload option. This option lets you upload files from your local computer or connect to files on OneDrive or a SharePoint site. With this change, you'll no longer be able to connect to files on personal OneDrive accounts. Let's say you want to quickly create a dataset from Excel, a CSV, or manually pasted data. You can now access that functionality through the New button and Dataset option in your workspace. We've also updated the Dataset option to take you to a new page with options to create a dataset off of an Excel, CSV, or pasting data. Once you select the option, the behavior used to generate the dataset is the same as previously used on the Get Data page. Here, we simply paste the data to generate a new dataset. From here, we can not only create a dataset, but also automatically create a default report based on the data from this dataset. Or we can jump to a blank report and build our own custom one from scratch. This demo, we created a dataset only. Once the dataset is created, you'll be taken to the dataset's details page in the Data Hub. Well, that wraps up our feature highlights for this month. Tell us in the comments, what's your favorite feature? Was there another feature for this month that you think that we should have spotlighted instead? Tell us in the comments. We would love to hear about it. Also, tell us in the comments how you like the new format of the feature update video. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.